Hey guys, this is Vikas once again and this is We Are Genius. Guys, today I am with a new episode around Raspberry Pi Zero. So, as you know, Raspberry Pi Zero doesn't come with onboard Ethernet. So, in this episode, what we are going to do is, interface the in-situ system module with the Raspberry Pi Zero so we can get a Ethernet connection to our Raspberry Pi Zero. But issue with in-situ SSDs, we don't get a faster connection compared to Raspberry Pi 2 or 3. But it works fine as long as we are into IoT applications. So guys, let's check it out. Let's get started. So guys, let's see how to connect the in-situ SSD with the Raspberry Pi Zero. As you know, in-situ SSD comes with SPA port to interface with other microcontroller devices. So we are going to need the SPA port of the Raspberry Pi Zero. So to connect, first let's plug in the cable to the in-situ SSD. And let's connect this to the Raspberry Pi Zero, the connectors. The first pin is the 3.3 volt input, so it will connect to the first pin of Raspberry Pi Zero, which is the 3.3 volt. So next is the ground pin, so connect it to the 6th pin of the Raspberry Pi Zero. Next is Mizo pin, so we'll connect to the Mizo pin of Raspberry Pi Zero, which is the pin number 21. So it's next is the Mozi pin, so we'll connect it to the pin number 19 of the Raspberry Pi Zero. It's actually same for all Raspberry Pi modules. The pin configuration are same. Next is the SCK pin that need to be connected to the pin number 23 of the Raspberry Pi Zero. And next is the SCK pin or the serial clock pin. Next is the CS pin that you need to connect to the SPA C0 pin of the Raspberry Pi Zero. I've connected. And along with the SPA interface, we need to provide the interrupt pin of the in-situ SSD connected to the Raspberry Pi Zero. So to do that, I'll just connect the jumper from interrupt pin of in-situ SSD to the pin number 22 of Raspberry Pi Zero. Now let's connect one Ethernet cable to the in-situ SSD module and connect it to your network. So guys, that's all with the connection of in-situ SSD module with the Raspberry Pi Zero. So let's tweak the config file so that the Raspberry Pi Zero OS or Raspbian JC which you are using will automatically detect the in-situ SSD module and treat it as default Ethernet port. So to do that, we'll log into the Raspberry Pi in using some HDMI monitor or something, and we'll tweak around the config.txt file.
So guys, to make the in-situ SSD module to be loaded by default, we need to change the config.txt file inside the boot folder. So to do that, just type in the command sudo nano slash boot, the folder containing it, and the file config.txt. So over here, just find out the dtparam SPA on and remove the hash tag. And over here, at the end of the file, just write dt overlay equals to ENC28J60. Now press Ctrl X, then Y, and press Enter. Now just reboot the Pi. So to reboot, just type in sudo reboot. So after the reboot, when you type ifconfig, you'll see something like eth0 with the DHCP address if DHCP is allowed in your network. So that's all. Now our module is ready with NC2HCT to be enabled networking in Raspberry Pi Zero. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again, and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there is a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.